Hey everybody, in this video we're going to be showing you how to paint one of the beautiful new Lumineth Realm-lord miniatures for Warhammer Age of Sigmar by Games Workshop, and that is a Vanari Dawnrider, which we're going to paint in the colour scheme of Iliatha. Now this is the white, orange and red colour scheme that you can see inside the battle tome, and it's a really nice colour scheme, and by following the methods we're going to show you in this video, it's easy to apply it to any miniature in the Lumineth army. Likewise, if you're painting a different colour scheme, this video is sure to be useful to you anyway, because we're also going to be showing you how to paint pure white armour and also a light grey horse. So we hope you enjoy this video and we'll see you at the desk. To paint your Lumineth elves in this colour scheme, the first thing that you should do is start out with an undercoat of grey Seer, which provides a fantastic starting point for the methods we're going to be using, because we've got a few contrast paints we're going to apply to the miniature to really establish those initial colours very quickly and very easily. Now also, whenever you're building a miniature like this that has a shield, it's a good idea to keep that shield separate, because there's quite a lot of detail hidden beneath it that's really tricky to get to if the shield's glued on. So you can see with my elf, I've kept it separate and then we'll glue it on at the very end. Now the first thing that we're going to do is to start to block in all the areas that are going to be the orange fabric, and in our case for this, the perfect starting point is to use Gryph-hound Orange, which is one of the contrast paints. To apply it, what you need to do is to get hold of a brush that holds a good tip, and I've got a regiment brush here from the Army Painter that does just that. It's also able to hold a fair amount of paint too, so it means I can paint for quite a while using this. And with this paint, I really recommend that you use a palette, because as we're putting it onto the miniature here, you don't just want to slap this on. You need to be controlled with it and just keep it just that orange fabric wherever possible. The less of it you get onto the armour, then the quicker it's going to be, and also the neater the overall finish of the miniature is going to be. So once you get some onto your palette like that, just twist away the excess and use some tissue to get rid of some of that paint from your brush like that, and load up fresh from the palette, because this way it's nice and controlled and you can just check to make sure you got that good tip on there as well. So, with that done, we're then ready to start applying it to all the fabric that we want to be orange. And this is generally the caparison on the horse, so you can see the fabric appearing beneath the armour, and also the fabric of the rider as well. So to start out with, all you've got to do is pick a starting point and essentially just start colouring in. So you can see I'm just going to very gently just run the brush across the area that I want to be orange, and bearing in mind that contrast paint is a bit like using felt tip pens, so once you've applied it to an area, just let it dry so it gives a nice smooth finish to things. And you see, you just really need to take your time just working your way around the fabric like this, just colouring it in. Now there are going to be times where it gets very tricky to get to the detail, especially around the rider. Things such as the trousers just here, you can see these are orange, and doing this area is a little bit tricky. Should you feel the need to, just switch to a smaller brush to give yourself some more control, and if you make any mistakes, just switch back to some grey Seer to neaten up. I finished blocking in all that orange now, and also neatened up any little splodges on the white armour, and with that done we can now move on to the next step, which is to shade that white armour, and the perfect thing to do for this is just to paint a coat of Apothecary White over it. So to apply it, I'm going to stick to that regiment brush that I was using in the previous step, and you can see I've also got some clean water now, and that's just to make sure I don't accidentally contaminate this with any orange colour, because there was quite a lot floating around in the water after the end of the previous step. But just like the first step, what we need to do is just get some of this ready, making sure the brush isn't overloaded. There we go, and once you've done so, it's just a matter of identifying all the armour panels and just applying this paint over them. So for example, the armour on the horse just here, just a matter of painting it on so it runs into the recess details like this. And there we are, the Apothecary White's been applied, giving some definition to that white armour, and with that done we can now move on to applying a third contrast paint, this time Black Templar though, and this is going to be for all the leather straps and also the reins. Now this contrast paint's a very strong one, so you need to be careful when applying it. So make sure you go for your smallest brush, I have here a detail brush from the Army Painter, and you can water it down with a little bit of water if you want to take the edge off it, just bear in mind you'll want to apply a second coat to get to a stronger black afterwards. But with this, essentially what you need to do is look for all those straps and just very carefully pick them out. So, for example, we're looking at areas such as just down here, you can see on the saddle where it goes down to the stirrups, we're looking for areas like that. And with that second coat, we just want to make it to be a solid black before we move on to the next stage. So you're looking at all these little areas such as down here and little straps such as this one just in here, very carefully applied, and the reins as well. And should you make any mistakes, just go back to some grey Seer, then paint the relevant contrast paint back over the top of it. I finished base coating all that Black Templar now, and you can see I also painted the texture on the back of the shield with that colour as well. And with that done, we can now move on to the next step, which is to neaten up some of these colours that we've applied so far by layering onto them. Now for the orange clothing, first of all, what we need is some Jokaero Orange, and to apply it, I'm going to start with my detail brush right from the very start. And with this, what I'm looking to do is to apply it smoothly over the orange details to basically neaten them up and stop them looking so blotchy in the middle on the large flat areas. So to do it, just make sure your paint's nicely thinned down as ever. There we go. And flowing well from your brush. And then using this, what we need to do is to apply it to the flat central areas of the fabric. So if we take a look at this part on the front just here, what I'm going to do is just start applying thin coats of it like this into these open areas in the middle, but not going quite into the corners to retain that warmth and shading that we've got from the contrast paint. And with that done, you can see the orange is now much neater, but also still retains the definition that we had from the contrast paint early on. And what we need to do now is do the same thing on that white armour. And for this, the colour we need is Corax White, which is a little bit lighter than grey sear, so shifting it closer towards a pure white. Now to apply it this time, I've gone back to my regiment brush, but of course, just feel free to go for whichever kind of brush that you want to use. And this paint can be a little bit thick, so really make sure you thin it down with your water on the palette to get it nice and smooth like that. There we go. Then, as before, just make sure the brush isn't overloaded. Maybe a bit thinner, I think. There we go. That's more like it. See, it's flowing very easily now from the brush. Just what I want. So just get rid of the excess off and some tissue, load up fresh, and then we're ready to start layering this onto that white armour plating. And as before, what we're looking to do is to avoid those recessed areas where the contrast settled the most. So you can see the kind of bluish line we've got in the recess. What I want to do is to smoothly apply this to the middle of the plate like this, not going quite into those corners. So just bring it up to that area like that, that little design there, work the way around it like this. So this way we get closer to white on these areas. Now, in addition, we need to pick out the trim because the vast majority of the armour is this colour. So for this, when you get to the trim, just use the side of your brush rather than the tip and just skim along it like that to get a nice highlight running along those areas really quickly and easily. And in addition, we also want to be doing this on the caparison too. You can see this kind of raised trim we've got going around it. For that, just like with the armour, just use the side of your brush and just turn the model so it feels comfortable to you, just gently skimming along that edge there like that to get that nice line running on that raised area there. So what you need to do now is carry on doing this on these edges, on the orange details, but also the white armour on the horse, the rider, and of course the shield as well. And there we go, the layering's been completed on the armour, giving a nice smooth finish to it. And that stage can take a little bit of time, but it's definitely worth really taking your time with it because it's such an important part of the main model. The smoother you get that, the better the final result is going to be. But with that done, we're now ready to start base coating some other colours onto the miniature. And for this, first of all, we need to do all the red details, for which we need Khorne Red. And then after that, we're going to do the silver details, for which we need Iron Hand Steel. But first of all, we need Khorne Red, and for this I'm going to be using a medium layer brush from Citadel for a little bit more control. And with this, what we want to do is just neatly block out anything we want to be red. Now, just bear in mind that red paints are very strong, so if you get a lot of this onto the white details, it can be quite tricky to neaten up again. So just be really careful, really take your time as you're using this colour. So once it's thinned down and ready, just make sure that the brush isn't overloaded. There we go, and then it's a matter of just looking for any details that we want to be red. Now, generally, what we wanted to look for here is any tassels, which you can see there's some on the reins just here, but they appear frequently around the miniature. For example, on the caparison down here, and they're on the lance as well. But also, we want to look for any fabric-like banners, so this one that's coming out the back just here. All this detail needs to be Khorne Red, and the crest on top of the helmet as well, just up here. In addition, there's some red on the shield, which is on the facing of it, so don't forget to paint that at this stage as well. And once you finish base coating all of that red, you're then ready to move on to Iron Hand Steel to paint in the blades of the weapons. And in the case of this model, it's just going to be the tip of the lance up here. And with those two colours now base coated, we can move on to the next step, which is going to be to wash both them at the same time. And for this, we need a black wash. Now, for this, you could use Dark Tone from the Army Painter, but I'm going to use Nuln Oil from Citadel. And to apply it, what you need to do is to get hold of a small brush than we were using previously, just for a little bit more control, because we must avoid getting this on the white detail, you see. So I'm using a medium layer brush here from Citadel, and I'm just going to put some of this onto the palette, and I'm going to draw it from the palette because I'll get that control that way. So at the moment, there's just way too much of that shade on the brush, so I can just get rid of the excess like that and some tissue, draw it fresh. This way it's going to be under more control because it's not quite so loaded up. And with this, what I'm going to do is just start painting it over the red and the silver details. For example, the plume up here. And like I said, when you're applying this, just be really careful of that white detail. So you can see as I get to these little kind of like orb parts we've got in the plume, it's going to be really careful just pushing the shade up to it, but not going over it. And there we are, with that done, we can now move on to the next group of base coats, which are all going to use the same colour wash again, this time a brown wash, so it's going to be much the same sort of sequence of what we've just done, so we're going to run through it quickly for you now. First of all, what we need is Castellax Bronze, and this is going to be to base coat all the scale mail, and then we're going to move on to Retributor Armour for the warmer gold details. After that, we need some Dawnstone for a few details scattered across the miniature, and then we're going to be adding some wash, this time Agrax Earthshade for that brown wash. But first of all, we need Castellax Bronze, and again, to apply this, I'm using that medium layer brush because these details are quite small now, and they also appear on the shields. Don't forget to get scale mail on that as well. But with this, all we've got to do is look for those scales, and the most obvious example is just down here on the horse's barding. All we need to do is to block in this whole area like this. With that bronze painted in, we can now move on to painting in the gold details using Retributor Armour. And these can be quite tricky to get to, so you can see I've switched to a detail brush here for a little bit more control. But essentially we're looking at the more decorative elements, such as these runes on the side of the armour. Next, we're ready to add some Dawnstone to the miniature, and this is first of all for the weapons. So for any spears or the lance such as this, we're looking to base coat the haft of it, and also for any grips that you can see. For example, on the other side, we've got the sword in the scabbard just here. We want to base coat the grip of it as well. Now, in addition, at this stage, we can start painting the horse, and what we need to do for it to begin with is to base coat all of its flesh with this colour, to prepare it for later on when we start painting in the details. And with those three colours now applied, we can finally move on to applying a coat of Agrax Earthshade over all of them. So we're looking at the bronze details, such as just here, the gold details as well, and also the grey for the weapons. But don't put this over the horse just yet, we are going to return to that later on. Allow that wash to completely dry, and then we're ready to move on to the next area of detail, which is going to be to paint in the skin. Now for this, all we need is to apply some Gulliman Flesh first of all, and then use a little bit of Nuln Oil to darken down the eyes. Once that's dry, we'll then move on to highlighting, for which all we need is some Flayed One Flesh. But first of all, we need Gulliman Flesh, and to apply it, I'm going to go straight to my detail brush. So go for your smallest brush here, because it's quite fine detail that we need to get to. And use the palette just to help make sure the brush doesn't have that much on there. There we go. You want that fine tip on there, you see. And with this, what we're going to do is just introduce this colour into the recess area of the helmet where you can see his face. So just in the middle, just there, all you've got to do is very gently just start poking the brush in like that, just letting the contrast paint run into the detail. Now, it's not just the face that can be seen, even though this is like the main part of it that stands out the most. You can also see some of his neck, so be sure to get that as well. Once that Gulliman Flesh is completely dry, the next thing to do is to just get a little touch of Nuln Oil and very gently just run it into the eyes. And once the Nuln Oil is also dry, we're then ready to move on to apply a highlight of Flayed One Flesh. And for this, we just need to pick out the bits of the skin that are standing out. For example, just the tip of the nose, just there, and also the chin. And with that, the flesh is complete, and now we can move on to the next phase of painting the miniature, which is to do some layering to neaten some colours up and also brighten them a little bit as well. And for this, first of all, what we need is Sycorax Bronze for the gold and bronze details, and then we're going to move on to Iron Hand Steel for the blade on the lance. After that, what we need is some Dawnstone for some layering and also a little bit of highlighting on the black too. And then finally, we're going to use some Khorne Red for the larger areas of red details, just to brighten them up a little bit. But first of all, we need Sycorax Bronze, and to apply this, I'm going to be using my detail brush. And this colour is a very thin paint. You'll see as I put it onto the palette, it initially seems quite strong, but when I thin it down with some water, you'll see it becomes very translucent. There you go, you see. And the reason why we're using this is because it will just add a subtle shift to the tone, but also it has a nice, beautiful shine to it. So really nice for elven things like this. What we need to do is just make sure we've got a small amount loaded. There we go. And with this, the goal is to layer it smoothly onto the brass details and the gold as well. So for example, if we look at the scales just here, all I'm going to do is just flick it on towards the bottom of them like this. And you see it just gives a really lovely shine to those details. It's very quick to do, just gradually working it towards the end of each one there like that. Now for the gold, again, what we want to do is a thin layer. So just as you're doing with those scales, just apply a very thin coat to this gold like this, very smoothly, just to give a really nice clean shine to it. With that layer done, you can now see we've got a really nice shine on all that metallic detail there, and now we need to do the same thing on the blade of the lance. So for this, we're returning to Iron Hand Steel, which I thinned down with a bit of water, and using a medium layer brush, it's just a matter of applying a thin layer all across the blade. There we are, that layer has been applied to the blade, and now I can move on to the haft of the lance and also the grips of any swords. And for this, we need to layer using Dawnstone. I'm still using my detail brush for this, and what we're looking to do is to apply a thin coat of it onto the flatter areas, but avoiding recessed areas where some of that shade settled earlier on. So for example, here you can see I'm just avoiding these little rings of gold that we've got, like that, to retain the definition from the shading as we get to those areas. Now, in addition, at this stage, we can do some quick highlighting on the black leather details, such as the reins. And for this, all you need to do is just angle your brush sort of side on, about 45 degree angle against the flat of the rein just there, and just gently skim along it like this. And this way, you get a nice, neat highlight appearing on those edges there like that. And just turn the model as you need to access these details so it feels comfortable to you. For the reins themselves going along here, instead, just turn your brush so it's side on, and just very, very gently skim along like this to get a highlight on the raised texture. And then finally, we're ready to return to Khorne Red to apply it as a layer onto the red details. And we're looking for the larger, flatter areas, such as this banner just here, and using a medium layer brush, you can see I'm painting it onto the flat areas in the middle, but avoiding recessed areas such as where it meets this little gold design, and also where it then arcs in. So you can see there's a crease on the inside just there, so I'm going to skip past that, look for the flatter area where it's standing out a bit more, and carry on just here. So I'm going to do this onto this banner here, a bit on the crest as well, and also on the face of the shield. And there we are, the layering is complete, and now we can move on to adding some highlights to the miniature. And for this, first of all, what we're going to do is finish off the orange detail by highlighting it using some Kislev Flesh. Now, to apply this, stick to that detail brush for lots of control here, because what we're looking to do is to pick out the tops of the creases on the fabric. And on the comparison, there really isn't any to do there because it's quite smooth, but on the clothing that the warrior's wearing, there are some bits to pick out. So just make sure you've got a thinned version there like that ready on your palette. And using this, what we just need to do is to look for those creases. So for example, if we take a look at the back of the leg just there behind the knee, what we're going to do is just look for the tops of those little folds that we've got there and just very gently run some of this colour along the very top. So just there, for example, and just along there, and just along there. So really it's just a matter of repeating this and all these creases that you can find on the suit, for example, as well, at the back here. And with that, the orange is complete, and now we can move on to finishing off all that white detail as well. And for this, what we need is a pure white highlight. So the colour I'm going to use is matte white from the Army Painter because it's got really good coverage. Really nice paint, this one. And to apply it, I'm going to be using that detail brush once more. And you can see I've just got a little bit of the paint already on the palette just here in this orange, so you can see what I'm doing with it. What you need to do is just thin it down as always. So there we go. So it's flowing well from the brush. And then with this, what we want to do is to pick out the edges of that white armour. Now, the great thing about these miniatures is that that edge is actually raised up from the armour itself. So doing this is really quite easy to do. All you got to do is look for these parts. So you see these like kind of bands that we've got going around the edges of the armour. Using the side of your brush, just skim along them like this to get a nice, neat highlight on all of them. And it's really just a process of doing this all the way around the miniature. And you can see, so long as you keep a light touch with it, it's very easy to get a nice, neat line all the way around. Now, in addition, at this stage, it's a good idea to do a little bit more on the trim on the orange details that we've got down here as well, because you can see some of the orange is still showing through a little bit. So with this colour, what we can do is bring it up to a pure white, and also that second coat over there will just help hide that orange that's just showing through. And with that highlight applied to the white, you can see it gives it a very clean and neat finish. And with that done, we can now move on to highlighting the remaining details on the miniature, all those smaller ones that we've got to do. So for this, first of all, what we need is some Wazdakka Red for the red details, followed by a very fine highlight of Cadian Fleshtone. And with that done, we're going to move on to Stormhost Silver for the silver and gold details, and then finally, some Administratum Grey to finish off the weapons. But first of all, we need Wazdakka Red, and again, I'm going back to that detail brush. And using this, what we need to do is to pick out the edges and most raised details on these features. So just make sure you've got that paint ready. There we go. And then it's just a matter of picking them out. And to begin with, what we can look at is some of these flatter surfaces like the banner. When it comes to areas like that, just use the side of your brush, just making sure there's not much on there. And just skim along the edge like this to get a nice highlight running along like that. And whenever you find a larger crease, just add a small bit of this paint going downwards along it. So for example, there's one just there. So I'm just going to go very lightly down there like that. Now, in addition, we need to pick out these tassels. And for these, they've got quite a bit of texture. So just very lightly just touch your brush to them. So that little ring that goes around that rope just there, that little bit there, and then a few following the strands going down like that. And when it comes to the larger texture, like on the crest and also the little part that we got just up there, that tassel around the lance, just switch to the side of your brush and just gently skim along like this to catch that raised bit of texture. Next, we're ready to add a fine highlight of Cadian Fleshtone to really finish off the red. And for this, what we want to do is just apply a small amount to the most prominent areas. So for example, on the crest that we've got here, all I'm going to do is add very small amounts of this like that onto the strands that stand out the most. So very gently, just looking for those ones that really stand out from the rest and just catch them with a bit of this colour towards the end. Now, we also want to do this on the lance, so you can see once again these parts that stand out, just a light skimming like that, not to take too much away from the red, just to add a bit of this colour to it. And for these little tassels, what we need to do is just do a bit running along the bottom and a bit towards the top just there as well. Now, in addition, we've got these larger areas such as the banner. And for this, what we're looking for is the curvature that sort of comes out from the rest of it more. So, for example, on this little curve just here, just apply a small amount there, then let it go into the recess and then apply another little bit as it curves out once again, just around here. And with that, the red is now complete. The next detail to highlight is going to be all the gold details, the brass details, and the silver details, for which we just need some Stormhost Silver. And with this, we just want to look for those sharp edges once more and just gently pick them out. Now, it's worth noting that the gold can be quite strong, especially when you're doing the gold. So as you can see just here, I'm being very light and very delicate as I'm applying it. Just look for those corners. Just very gently skimming the brush across them there like that. The trickiest part out of all of this to do, though, is going to be those runes that are on the side of the horse's barding. And for this, it's just a matter of really bracing your hands, keeping yourself nice and steady, looking for those edges and just very gently running along them like that. See, the movement I'm making is just to move my brush sideways, using very close to the tip, but actually the side of it, just to catch that raised texture on the edge like that. But doing this correctly is really all about bracing your hands, just like I'm doing here, to keep them as steady as possible. And finally, we just need a small amount of Administratum Grey to finish off the grips of the weapons and also the haft of the lance. And for this, we're just looking for the edge of the texture, for example, around here, and just gently pick it out. So on sword handles, it's going to be things such as just there. But when it comes to the lance, instead, what we're looking for is those little rings where we've got the gold details in, like there, for example, and down there. And for this, all you do is add a little highlight underneath each one. And with those highlights now applied, the model is very nearly finished. All we need to do is to finish painting the horse. And for this, the first thing that we need to do is give it some shading. So for this, I'm going to use some Basilicanum Grey, which is one of the contrast paints. But this paint's a little bit too strong straight out of the pot. So what I'm going to do is mix it with some contrast medium, just take the edge off. This will give some nice subtle shading on the horse. Now, once that's completed, we're then going to move on to some Black Templar to darken down some specific areas on it. And then finally, we just need some Administratum Grey to highlight it. But first of all, we need that Basilicanum Grey and Contrast Medium mix. And to make this, what we want is a roughly 50-50 mix. So using a regiment brush here from the Army Painter, I'm going to start out with the grey just so you can see what I'm doing with it. I'm going to start with one brushful and then two. There we go. Then wash it to make sure I don't contaminate the medium with any colour. And we want roughly the same. It doesn't have to be exact. If in doubt, add more medium than you think you're going to need. But I'm just going to start out with one, put it next to it, and then two, and then start mixing them together. And there you go. You see it just dilutes it, takes the edge off, makes it a bit of a softer colour. And with that done, we're then ready to start applying it. So the first thing to do is just check to make sure the brush isn't overloaded so it doesn't run out of control. And there we go. And with that ready, all we need to do now is start painting this onto the horse's flesh. So we're looking at this area to begin with. All you do is paint on like this, and you'll see it's very subtle on the raised, flatter areas. But in those recesses, it gives a really nice soft shading, such as just under there beneath its jaw. So all you need to do now is paint this all over the grey parts of the horse, not worrying about the mane and the tail, because we're going to move on to those next. Once the contrast paint's completely dry, we're then ready to move on to some Black Templar, and this is to paint on the muzzle of the horse to darken it down. So around here first of all, and then in addition, we need to paint in the eyes, and for this, once again, just run some Black Templar into the recess like this. And there we are, the Black Templar's now dry, and you'll notice as well, I forgot to mention, but I also painted the hooves in with that colour. With that done, we can now move on to Administratum Grey to apply as a highlight on the horse's body. And with this, what we're looking for is all the sharper edges that stand out. For example, around the ears just here. Also, we want to look for things like around the nostrils, around the mouth, the jawline, all features like that. And there we are, the horse's body is now highlighted, and we can move on to finishing off the miniature with the final detail, which is to paint the mane and the tail. Now for this, what we need to do is first of all base coat them using some Karak Stone, and then wash over them with Agrax Earthshade, and once that's completely dry, all we need is a Ushabti Bone to finish them off. But first we need that Karak Stone, and to apply it, I'm sticking to that detail brush, and with this, you just need to start blocking out these areas initially, just with a nice neat base coat. So remember to thin your paint down so it helps it flows smoothly onto the model, doesn't obscure any detail, and once you've done so, it's just a matter of picking these areas out. So first of all, we want to do the main, so around here, and the way to apply this is kind of in this angle like this, moving the paint downwards towards the base, then moving away to create a slightly rough line where it meets the back of the horse's neck. Now in addition, we need to paint in the tail, and also some very small details around the hooves. See these little tufts of hair that we've got around here? Be sure to pick those out at this stage as well. With that base coat applied, we're now ready to move on to some Agrax Earthshade, and all we need to do is to paint this all over the mane, tail and the tufts of fur around the hooves. And once that wash is completely dry, you're then ready to move on to highlighting these details using some Ushabti Bone. And once again, I'm using the detail brush, and highlighting these details is just like when we were doing the crest on the helmet earlier on, using the side of your brush to gently skim this texture like this, catch the raised areas to give them a nice quick highlight really easily and simply. Now once you've done this, you're then ready to glue on the shield with a little dot of super glue, and then you're ready to base your miniature. As ever, it's entirely up to you how you base your model, but for me, I'm going to go for a grasslands base. And with the base now fully painted, this Dawnrider is complete and ready to charge into battle in the Mortal Realms. So when you're painting a model in this colour scheme, it's a little bit unusual in that it requires being as neat as possible right from the very start. And whilst you can make mistakes and shouldn't worry about them because you can always neaten them up, the neater you are, the faster you're going to find painting this colour scheme is, because the quicker it'll be to paint in that white armour. Anyway, we really hope you enjoyed this video and learned something from it, and we'll see you all again very soon.